and welcome to this tutorial on rotating object towards target position in Unity. Here I have an arrow. When I press left mouse button, its direction will start following the mouse position. When I release the mouse, it is shot. Previously we were shooting balls and they didn't need rotation to look realistic. But for pointy objects, we at least need to make them look towards the target. This video is a continuation of physics-based movement in this environment, like shooting the object to target position by calculating the velocity. But this video will focus on one thing. Make the arrow or any object that you would use to point at its movement direction before it takes off. That's why this will not explain how we are shooting it. Let's go through what is going on again. When mouse pressed down, arrow starts to follow mouse position. If there is nothing behind the mouse, arrow stops following it and stays at its last rotation. When mouse is released and when there are objects with colliders behind the mouse position, the arrow is shot. Otherwise, arrow is not shot. Most simply, what we do here is setting forward vector of the object that we are shooting to movement direction. Here, as a thrown object, I use this arrow prefab. It has collider and rigid body. We set the rigid body to not use gravity, so if no collision, no intervene to our rotation. For ease of changing the model, I use the model as the child of the object and adjust the collider accordingly from parent transform. For example, this arrow only sticks to target objects from its point side. The reason we are setting the forward vector to movement direction is how we expect our game object to look towards the movement direction. For example, if the arrow's pointy side was looking at y direction, we would use up direction of that transform. Here the arrow follows a linear movement and is shot from almost ground, so the arrows on targets do not look very appealing. If the spawner, which is the spawning position, moved a little up, arrows look better on targets. We said we are setting the forward direction of the game object to movement direction. Let's see how we do that in our code. In this implementation, we have spam shooter that tells the spam how to be shot. Currently, we use linear velocity with no spin, but this time we will rotate the object towards the movement direction before shooting it. In the update, we check if the object is shot. If shot is true, only if the spawner shooter signaled the object to be shot. If it was shot, we don't need further look for input and return from running the below code. Otherwise, we have an object that was not shot yet. If player is pressing down on left mouse button, we call rotate towards target function, which does background work to ready the object rotation towards the target. If the left mouse button is released, we shoot object by calling shoot function. In rotate towards target, we create a ray from mouse position towards face position from our camera. If the ray hits any object with collider, that means we have a target. Using the hit position, we call rotate towards mouse function. In this one, hit position is the target position that we want our object to be looking at. Direction vector starts from the position of the object and ends in target position. When we set this vector to spawn object's forward vector, we have it looking at that direction. Mention of look at. Since our object points towards its forward direction, we can set its rotation to the rotation calculated by Quaternion LookRotation using direction vector. This will return a rotation needed to be looking towards the direction provided as the variable here. If your object looks at another direction other than the forward, you should follow the above approach and set that direction to look direction. This was how we can make our object to look at the ever-changing target position in our Unity project. If you have a target position to look at and know the looking direction of your game object, you can transform what has been told in this tutorial to your scenario. That's it for this video. I hope this will be helpful in your projects, and if there was a point not clear, please let me know in the comments. If you like this video and want to see more of these, give this one a like and subscribe for the future ones. If you are interested in this kind of videos that use physics to move and do other things, I am motivated to create videos on them. This is a part of series that was born from that motivation. Each video, I try to focus a specific part that could be used separately from this series. For the next one, which is most likely will be very short, I plan the object to not stick if it collides with the target after falling down from non-target collision. And then I want to create the video of scoring according to object position on target. With that, I hope to see you in the next explorations, and bye bye!